when I lay with my back to the wall because who I thought would come through the door was vaguely haunting. My body was hot and my heart raced, and I tried to tell them that I heard things when the lights went out. Things that I saw standing on the corner, and bullets that ricocheted off of the doors of hand-me-down Hondas and struck the souls of kids who balanced on thin lines between innocent and involved. And caution tape with, do you know who was involved? Placed on sidewalks in front of those who wouldn't talk even if they seen it all. Bathroom stalls, infested with stories about young girls handing themselves over to young boys who were on the quest to find out what it means to be a man so they never got a chance to embrace her as a woman. She, or he, and even them. They whispered from the volcanic cracks in the wooden floor, and they told me bedtime stories that were capable of paralyzation. He got hit 2 times in his lower back and enjoyed his permanent vacation with being physically complacent. His soul, peacefully resting in the newly renovated attic while his mind banged on the cellar door of the basement. Number blocks, ticked and never being welcomed, and they insist that they love it here. The visual is the sensual. The lights dim the further you go up from down, and its pitch black blocks were live and swallowed with the teethless mouths of unheard sounds and rounds, basketballs, simultaneously bouncing into an enter at your own risk abyss and vulnerability insinuating that you could have all of it. Lies engraved on the side of walls, and graffiti makes love to the bricks as if it was last time having all of it. The streets never love you and they still fall for it. They hung from the cobwebs in every corner, and I felt spiders tiptoeing down my spine like tarantulas on vine, and I tried to tell them I heard things when the lights went out. They won't really listen to me, but I'm trying to tell them that I heard things when the lights went out. Corner stores, leaking with backpacks full of stolen snacks, $4 sandwiches wrapped in an aluminum embryo that reeks of belly touching love and repetitive pause in between lessons due to the cacophony of sirens, young cubs who never became lions. Underestimated, ostracized my opportunity and told they aren't trying. When my foot slipped from under the well, circulated around the household sheets, I could feel it come from under my bed. And through the licorice dark, I saw red. In my nightmares, I never bled. Poetry that dissects the most intricate pieces of York that will never be read. Kids losing friends and forced to reminisce on what was said. Conversations that were only heard when the lights went out.